Assalamualaikum everyone. Today's lecture is about English grammar. That what is English grammar? So first of all, we will read about the definition of grammar. So what is grammar? Grammar is the system and structure of a language. It is a system and structure of a language, and we have different rules and regulations. For example, if we talk about Urdu language has its own grammar. Same is the case with English language. English language has its own grammar. For example, if we learn a simple rule that in order to make a sentence, we have to put subject at the start, then we have verb, and then we have object. So basically, this is the rule, this is the grammar. Now we will talk about it. What are the grammatical elements? First one is phonics, morpheme, word, phrase, clause, sentence, paragraph, and essay. These are the different grammatical levels. First of all, there is a phonics. Then we combine phonics, it form morpheme, and the next step is word. Then we have phrase, clause, sentence, paragraph, and essay. So first of all, we will look at phonics. That what are phonics? I had shown one picture over here. Phonics. What is meant by phonics? Phonics basically deals with sounds. For example, we have a, b, k. So these are different phonics. And when we combine different phonics together, they form morpheme. And now we will learn that what is morpheme. Morpheme is basically a smallest unit of a word. For example, if we have a word children. So what is morpheme? When we divide this word into its syllable, chill and run. So this is morpheme, the simplest unit of a word. Fine. Now we will discuss that what is word. So how you can define a word? A word is basically a single distinct meaningful element. The whole word child is a word. Fine. Okay students, there are two type of words, literal words and functional words. Literal words are those which have full meaning. For example, noun, adjective, verb, they are conveying some proper meaning. And what about functional words? They are those that are basically using in a sentence in a smaller way or general way. For example, we have prepositions, conjunctions, interjection. They both have some importance. Literal words and functional words both are important. Now we will discuss that what is phrase and clause. So what is phrase? Group of words which are conveying proper which convey some meaning but not the proper meaning is called as phrase. But those words which convey proper meaning is known as clause. And clause is always a subject and a predicate. Fine. On the table, the blue sky is a phrase, and I have quoted examples of clause as well. You can learn these examples, and this is very important concept. You know, students get confused between phrase and a clause. Now you people will think that what is meant by a predicate? So predicate is basically the main verb. Okay, jaise hum bolte hain boys place, boys is a subject and predicate is a place. Now we will discuss that what is sentence. Group of words which convey proper meaning is called sentence. And we have a one rule for making sentence, that is we have to place subject at the start, then we have verb, and then we have object. The first letter will always be the capital one, and in the end we put full stop. So this is the rule in order to make a sentence. There is one more confusion between clause and sentence because the definitions are same. First of all, we will discuss that what is the difference between phrase and clause. So phrase do not contain a subject and predicate. We don't have any proper sentence structure. While on the other hand, clause contains subject and predicate. Phrase do not convey a complete thought, but clause always conveys a complete thought. And phrase cannot stand alone in a sentence. But on the other hand, independent clauses can stand alone in a sentence. Now we will learn that what is the difference between clause and a sentence. The difference between clause and a sentence is mentioned here. Clause only contains subject and predicate, while sentence contains subject, verb, and object. Clause conveys a complete thought, but sometimes now sentence always completes the complete thought. Fine. So this is the difference between clause and sentence. And when we combine different sentences together, they form a paragraph. And when we combine different paragraphs together, then they form an essay. So basically, in today's lecture, we have discussed the grammatical elements. They started from phoneme and then end on essay. That was the end of the lecture. If you found any query, any question in your mind, you may ask in the comment section. I will answer. Okay, students, thank you so much. Stay blessed and have a nice day. Kindly please share and like the video as well.